Let's take a look at one other problem that's similar to this one, and then I'll show you one that's slightly different. So let's say that we are dealing with the problem 4w minus 1 over 3w plus 6 minus w minus 1 over 3 equals w minus 1 over w plus 2. Now, I notice that this last expression has a w plus 2, so we need that in our least common denominator. And the middle expression here has a 3, so that needs to be in our least common denominator. So we know we need a 3 and a w plus 2. However, this one here is not factored. We need to factor that to see what it turns into, to see if there's anything else we need. And I notice that there's a 3 in common to both of them. So let's factor out the 3, and we get w plus 2. So notice that this particular expression has both the 3 and the w plus 2. And this one has a 3, and this one has a w plus 2. So the only things we need in order to be able to cancel all the denominators out is a 3 and a w plus 2. So that's what our least common denominator is. Our LCD is 3 times w plus 2. So we're going to multiply this whole equation by 3 times w plus 2. We'll distribute it to this one over here, which will be 3 times w plus 2 times the 4w minus 1 over 3 times w plus 2. Remember, we leave the denominators factored. And then before I continue on, I notice there's a subtraction here, and I did not distribute it. So let's distribute the subtraction across the top of this fraction and then distribute our least common denominator. That way we won't make an error with our positives and negatives. So we're going to do this times that, which will be 3 times w plus 2 times negative w plus 1 over 3 equals, and now distribute it to the last one here. Let's go back and cross cancel. I notice the 3's cancel and the w plus 2's here. That leaves me with a 4w minus 1. On the next expression, the 3's cancel. And I'm left with an entire w plus 2 times negative w plus 1. So this needs to FOIL right here. So let's do that. W times negative w is negative w squared. W times 1 is w, and 2 times negative w is negative 2w, and 2 times 1 is 2. So that takes care of that fraction. And then in the last section, these w plus 2's cancel. And we just need to distribute our 3 to the w minus 1. So 3 times w is 3w, and 3 times negative 1 is negative 3. Now, let's go ahead and simplify. I have a lot of like terms on that left-hand side. So I'm first going to put my negative w squared, and then I notice that I can combine the 4w, the w, and the negative 2w. They're all like terms. And that ends up giving us 3w. And then combining the negative 1 and the 2, I get positive 1. So now I notice that I have a squared term. So again, I need 0 on one side and I need to factor. And I like to keep my things that are squared positive. So what I'm going to actually do is move everything from the left side to the right side. So I'll add w squared to both sides. And that will move this away. And this is a positive 3w, so I'll subtract 3w, which will make that go away. And I'll subtract 1, which will make that go away. So I end up with 0 over here. On this side, notice the 3w's cancel. So I have my w squared, and the negative 3 and the negative 1 is negative 4. And now I can factor, and notice I have a difference of squares. This factors into w plus 2 times w minus 2. So I'm going to solve two equations, w plus 2 equals 0. The other equation will be w minus 2 equals 0. On the first one, subtracting 2 from both sides, I get negative 2. And that's one possible solution. Adding 2 to both sides to this would be w equals 2. And that's the other possible. But before we do anything else and say what our solution is, we need to check those solutions and see if we would have any extraneous solutions. And I notice that if I take a look at my denominators in the original expression, negative 2 would make this 0. It would also make this 0. So negative 2 is the restriction on our w's. And I notice negative 2 is one of our solutions. So we will go ahead and just cross that out, which makes the only possible solution 2. If you get to the end and all the solutions that you come up with end up being extraneous solutions, then what you would just state is that there's no solutions to the particular problem, because sometimes that happens. If negative 2 had been the only answer and it does make the denominator 0, then we would just say no solutions. In this case, we had 2, one worked, one didn't. Now let's take a look at one other special kind of problem that is also a rational expression. This rational equation is going to be negative 3 over w plus 2 equals w over w plus 2. Now, on this particular problem, notice that we have one fraction on each side. The previous problems had multiple fractions on at least one side of the equal sign. So since this has more than, has only one fraction on each side of the equal sign, we can still use the process we did use in the last two problems, or we can do a shortcut. The shortcut is the result gets you to the result of multiplying by the least common denominator a little faster. Now keep in mind this only works when you have a single fraction, like we do here, on each side of the equal sign. If there's more than one fraction on either side of the equal sign, you cannot do this process. And this process is called cross multiplying. When you cross multiply, what you do is you kind of make a cross with these loops. And what you do is this loop here gives you a w and a w plus 2 in it. You multiply those two together and write them down right below. Then you carry down your equals and you multiply what's in the second loop of our cross, which is negative 3 and w plus 2. This line that we get right here with the expression that we just found is the result of what we will get if we multiply by the least common denominator. And that's if we multiply by the least common denominator of w plus 2 times w plus 2 using both of them. However, this particular one, multiplying by w plus 2 would just eliminate it. We'll do one more like this, but that's not quite the case. So what we're going to do now is we've eliminated our fractions by cross multiplying, so we'll simplify and solve. So distributing the w here, we get w squared plus 2w. Distributing the negative 3, we get negative 3w minus 6. Now, we need 0 on one side, and then we can factor and solve. So I'm going to go ahead and add 3w to both sides, and add 6. That makes these go away, and the right-hand side has a 0, and the other side turns into w squared plus 5w plus 6. And again, this has three terms, and we can use our shortcut. So the things that multiply to get 6 and add up to 5 are 2 and 3. So this will be w plus 2, w plus 3 equals 0. And then if I go ahead and solve this one by adding a negative 2 to both sides, I get w equals negative 2. If I solve this one by adding a negative 3 to both sides, I get w equals negative 3. And notice that the negative 2 is an extraneous solution, so we cross it out, and the only possible solution is the negative 3. Let's look at